Coronavirus U.S. lived Trump fumes as White House staffers test positive and death toll nears 80,000. It's hard, of course, to keep up with all the coronavirus news, but here's some of it in summary. 15,000 people have been given antibody tests in New York with an overall infection rate of 19.9%. When you look at disasters like emergencies, hurricanes, floods, he says, the cruel irony is the poorest people pay the highest price. New York Governor Andrew Cuomo says total hospitalizations, intubations and new coronavirus cases are all down over the past 24-hour period, in his daily briefing from Albany. We would like to see this number dropping at a far faster rate than it has been dropping. Cuomo says three children in the New York area have died from an inflammatory illness, potentially related to COVID-19, saying, this is the last thing we need at this time with all the anxiety we have now for parents to have to worry if their youngster is infected. In New York City, which has been hit hard by the coronavirus, the subway system is now being shut down between 1 a.m. and 5 a.m. each night to allow the disinfecting of trains. The buses are not for transportation, but may serve as a place for individuals to escape the elements in the short term, according to a prepared statement from New York City Transit President. We are providing these buses only during this cold snap and expect the city to continue to step up and take responsibility for providing safe shelter for those individuals experiencing homelessness. On Friday, the governor tweeted some facts which make very worrying reading for parents in New York, of which I am one. Here again is our chief reporter Ed Pilkington's piece on the Trump administration's eagerness to reopen the U.S. economy despite warnings from public health advisors such as Dr. Redfield, as I am a Lincolnhead and rather too fond of reminding people about it. Here's a few highlights of Lincoln biographer and former Clinton aide Sidney Blumenthal's new piece for the Washington Post. It's about Donald Trump's decision, last weekend, to conduct an interview at the Lincoln Memorial, and to claim worse treatment than the 16th president, the one who won the Civil War, ended slavery and was shot dead on a trip to the theater. As great as Lincoln might have been, Trump, with his martyr envy, has felt a compulsion to diminish him whenever he raises his name. Even murdered, Lincoln was treated better than Trump. Again, Trump wins. Wow, highest poll numbers in the history of the Republican Party, he tweeted. Trump's self-celebration has had a persuasive effect on present-day Republicans, who, according to an Economist YouGov poll that appeared after Trump's projection, favored Trump over Lincoln 53% to 47%. In manner and experience, Buchanan was Trump's opposite, dignified, polite, abhorring vulgarity. Trump, echoing Buchanan, similarly abdicates his responsibility in the face of the pandemic. Effectively cutting the states loose, he stated that the federal government is a mere backup, infamously declaring, I don't take responsibility at all. Here's our write-up of the Yahoo News report on what Barack Obama reportedly thinks, note couching, skepticism fans of the Trump administration's decision to drop the case against Michael Flynn and the White House's management of the coronavirus outbreak. It's not pretty for Trump, obviously. A weekend editor's lot can be a lonely one and his load heavy, although I wouldn't expect anyone to feel sorry for me, don't worry, but that load can be lightened by just 11 magic words. There is no White House briefing on the press schedule today. We're not due to hear from Donald Trump or from Kayleigh McEnany, his combative but more available to be combative than her predecessor, so kudos for that new press secretary. Obama, Trump virus response, an absolute chaotic disaster. Yahoo News has a big fat scoop, having obtained what it says is tape of Barack Obama talking to his alumni association about the Justice Department's decision to drop the case against Michael Flynn, the former Trump national security advisor, who pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI about his contacts with Moscow. But further down the Yahoo story, which is by Michael Isikoff, a chap who knows his Russia onions, as it were, Obama reportedly addresses Donald Trump's handling of the coronavirus outbreak.
It's not like Donald Trump to take such words lying down, of course, so one would expect a cannonade of tweets to blast from the White House portico, at some point soon, aimed at the Obamas in Kalorama. Speaking of the White House, the virus has circled closer to the president himself. This week, a valet, who served Donald Trump, the Vice President Mike Pence's press secretary, who is married to senior policy aide Stephen Miller, and Ivanka Trump's personal assistant, have tested positive. Thanks for watching. Please do like, share, and subscribe.